Hey everybody, Christopher Odd here, and I have somebody with me who needs no introduction at this point, but I'm going to let him introduce himself.
Hello everybody, I'm Luckless Lovelocks.
Yeah, great. So...
such a bad intro.
Well, maybe your part, mine was pretty exceptional.
You're right.
We're going to head in to the city. And Luckless, you're pretty good at doing like a quick little recap. Can you maybe share what
beyond
are we doing?
These walls, the dead
I think the larger quest that we were trying to solve in that area over there is where the undead was coming from, right?
Right.
And I don't think we really resolved that.
Yeah.
We did enjoy fighting each other though.
Yeah. Unintentionally.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I enjoyed that a lot.
So we were discussing where we should head next, and we think we're going to go talk to Selenia and head to the inn, or the tavern, I should say, to talk to the guy that we saved from that, like, hut.
Mm-hmm.
And then let probably talk to Captain Aureus and Aru about potentially maybe sharing, like, where the dead were coming from, or those burial grounds or whatever, and, etc., etc.
Just kind of wrap stuff up in town, I think.
Yeah, and I think there's a lot to do, actually. Yeah, and I think we're probably going to go through... I'm running towards Selenia, by the way. I think we're going to go through ebbs and flows of, lots of combat, because it's, like, each encounter is not short. Which is fun, because it's kind of like a mini tactical puzzle, and I like that. And then there'll be patches where we're doing, like, town stuff and progressing the narrative and figuring out, like, what the hell's going on here. So.
Yeah, absolutely. I like that. It kind of breaks the flow up.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, okay, I can talk to her, so I'm gonna jump in.
Okay.
But it's being weird. I have to talk to, like, her arm or something. There we go.
So good to see you again, Source Hunter.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Go, listening in.
Well, there's not much going on here, actually. We could discuss the undead, maybe?
From some vile source. I could
no,
make a
nothing.
Feeble pun about your hunting for said source,
okay.
But no, the undead are no laughing matter.
I'm going to ask about the pact she made
so
with Legionnaires.
The Pact of Volunteers. Many Legionnaires will do whatever it takes to go home, which is why I personally
we've heard her say this, right?
Orders the moment
yeah.
They make the chances of survival during these sorties are only about 1 in 10. I shall be very glad to share what information I can give you.
Okay. The expeditions.
By all means.
Okay, maybe hear about the burial mounds?
My legionnaires.
There we go.
They all perished?
Okay.
How fate has treated them wantonly. And if it weren't for you, the archaeologist would surely have died as well. He has much to be thankful for. Were that I had.
Yes. Now, have we talked to her about the lighthouse? Yeah, we
not
did.
Not since we cleared it, right?
Well, you know, we did because those two asshats threw us under the bus.
The two cowards. Right.
I'll grant you that the two survivors of that expedition were a bit cowardly.
Yeah, there you go.
But
see,
I can hardly.
Me and Selenia.
Everyone
we're
wants
like
to
one.
Go home, even if that means indulging in deception.
Okay, now let's get a refresher on this old church.
Churches have churchyards, and churchyards attract necromancers. So goes the sinister logic.
Okay, so necromancers. Got it. Fun. All right.
I think that old church might have a connection with what's her name again? The apprentice, that guy's apprentice.
Evelyn?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm looking at Evelyn's secret lair. It's northwest-ish, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
And straight to the north was all of the religious stuff that we talked about with those other guys. So, yeah. You're probably right. It's probably tied together. So what do you think, in tavern? Should we go for a drink or 10?
I think, why don't we go over to the captain and Aru, since they're right here.
Yeah, okay. I pretty much had enough of your logic, so if we could just go ahead and run around like
just
idiots.
Just do stuff randomly? Okay. Yeah,
there's
we'll
also two minor healing potions on this floor that I'm just going to take. They're probably ours.
The hell am I going?
No idea.
Totally not facing the right way. There we go.
Okay, I'm going to talk to Aureus.
Hold on!
I'm going to charm his pants off.
His panties off? Are you wearing those panties?
You mean like... IRL? No, never mind. Yes, I am.
Oh, okay. What now?
Okay, Jake's murder, himself arresting someone, or additional questions?
If you must.
Does the name Brachus ring a bell? Have we talked to him about this?
Brachus.
Would you take
does me? Ring, but I'm not sure. I can't remember what it's from.
That accursed name rings a goddamn carillion. He was the last sorcerer king. A frightful
warrior. Oh, yeah.
He was the one that all those guys were being slain by the working army for or whatever.
Yeah, him. Yeah.
We may well stand on unholy ground right now. For they say his remains were buried in what is now Sicyl. The Mad King from Mad City.
So I'm pretty sure that's the source of the undead scourge here.
Yes, I would agree. Rue tells me he suspects a sect might be at work around Sicyl.
Yes, and he also spends most of his time in the guise of a cat, licking God's knows which body parts. Sects.
Fair enough.
Sorcerers. You'll be seeing flying carpets next.
And I don't know if we asked him about the orcs on the beach, but I'm going to.
I'd say they're looking for weak spots in our defenses. They can't make an attack over land for fear of Ahu's magical machines, so they're trying their luck by sea. They okay. won't succeed, though. Not against the Legion.
And I'll ask him about the undead to see if it's anything new, but...
Bravo! Figured that one out, did you? I haven't been stuck here for 2 years because we're being besieged by fluffy kittens.
I don't recall him telling us this stuff.
Those brain-feasting freaks out there keep on coming. And
but
it takes
a lot
all
of
the sword arms and all of Ahu's half-baked contraptions to keep them at bay. Keeping them at bay, that is all we do. Were that I could break their backs once and for all.
Okay, and about the Legion?
We are the pride of Rivalon, to be found and to be seen everywhere. We don't hide in the dark and lurk in corners like some I could mention. No, we protect the civilized from the barbaric, and we do so impeccably.
And I might as well finish it off with Sicyl.
How am I?
I think he's really enjoying it.
Are you spoiling
yeah, sounds like
fight,
it.
Hunter? Are you? Sicyl stinks of fish, reeks of orcs, and on a good day, the wind disperses the stench of decomposing corpses. I can't remember the last time I had a proper piece of steak, and by now, I retch at the mere sight of sardines. So in conclusion, I am not enjoying Sicyl.
Maybe he should just leave, you know?
Yeah, you would think so. Now my question is... Sorry.
Hold on, I just want to ask him a bit about the murder,
the
see if there's anything new.
Hunter.
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, joyous hour.
I was just testing to see if everything gets removed, but everything comes
must.
Back. So, and there's no indication as to what we've asked and what we haven't.
Okay.
Okay, let's ask about the murder.
Yes.
Yeah.
Discovered anything?
Okay, well, Esmeralda.
Surely you have exhausted all the evidence that was to be found. No.
Okay. So I don't
good
think there's
bloodhound
anything.
No. Knows when the trail has gone cold. So be a good dog now, won't you?
And Jake's corpse we've talked to him about.
Stolen?
Yeah.
Gods, what a f- He has a lot to answer for. But not as much as the one that did the bribing in the first place.
Did we call
Guess
out Evelyn?
Your mission is pretty clear, isn't it? Off you go to find this
I don't think we could.
Snatcher.
Oh, yeah, okay. I don't think we did that.
What is in her diary certainly seems to implicate she dabbles in sorcery. Well, you're supposed to be the source hunter, aren't you? Go hunt some source.
Yeah, it's that easy. I get it. Okay, cool. Let's go talk to Aru, and then I guess we head out to the tavern. What is this contraption that he's got in the back here? I guess it's probably, like, fueling those turrets that he has.
Source Hunter, welcome. Welcome.
Oh, okay, I'm in.
Okay, I don't think there's anything new here with him, man.
Okay.
So, I say we leave...
Do it. All right. I thought there might be something new.
That's okay. It's good to touch base. No downside. All right. So to the tavern, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
Which, if memory serves, yep, nailed it. And once we get there, we're looking for the guy that we saved. What's his name? It's escaping me. Probably because we only saw him for like 10 seconds. Do you remember?
No, not off the top of my head.
Well, you just have a terrible memory. That's great.
I definitely do.
Don't worry, bro. We are in the same camp in that regard.
He was an undead connoisseur.
Yes. That is a fact. That.
Aren't we all, though?
We're becoming that, yes.
Ooh. I meant to use the pyramid, but I sent it to you instead.
Awesome. Do you want that back, or...?
Sure, I'll take it back.
There you go. Okay, so who are we looking for? Oh, Wolfram! Never That's his name.
That troop of eager imbeciles we sent to the northern cave.
He was even a title.
Do I see
Welcome
like
be my friend,
yeah.
Waitress. Another round of beers, if you please.
Absolutely. All right, so I'm going to get right to business with him. So you know a lot about the undead, right?
Quite so.
Oh, he's told us about this.
So to speak. The combination of archaeology
yes.
and a case of insight. I'm an archaeologist and connoisseur of the undead because of my expertise.
Yeah, so we know all of this, so he's not helping us at all.
Jeez.
All right, great. So this has been riveting.
Tell me.
I think we should just head out.
Have you ever
sure.
had
yeah, I don't. I thought we'd find more here, but I guess not. But there was one place, actually, that I wanted to check out.
And what was that?
I'm going to port to the harbor.
Okay.
And I don't know if you want to jump to me or not.
Yeah, I will. I just got to find my teleport.
I found this place when I was looking around before.
Okay.
The warehouse.
Oh, right. I remember you saying this. This is when we found the trapdoor.
Yeah.
Okay. You want to talk
Are
to-
Are you in on the conversation?
Yes, I am. Go ahead.
Okay. I'm Sergeant Curtius, proud protector of this house of Legion Goods. So let's hear about you.
Curtius is my name. The Legion is my calling.
Great.
Okay, and what's in the room?
This is a storing house for Legion supplies. Perhaps the most important building in the realm, by my and others' estimation. And I, Sergeant Curtius, have been trusted to guard it.
He looks exactly like Aureus.
He does.
Like, twins.
Like, big purple lock, too. That's interesting.
Yeah, I mean, that's clearly inviting me to pick that.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay, that's it? That's all you got?
I guess so.
Okay.
I guess the rest is for us to figure out. Look what's in there. You can even see. It's kind of an unfair advantage, but for sure I'm getting in there.
Kind of a mess in there.
Let's see what else is in here.
There's a few other characters. There's Moira here.
Maybe you can start with the two idiots hiding their pet orc here? What? Bet you that's behind the locked door.
Maybe. That's it.
What about Florius? Humble warehouse.
Okay, well, tell me about yourself first.
I tell ya. This gig sure beats getting my toes bitten off by zombies out in the field.
I bet it does.
We warehouse guards don't have to do much apart from stroll the perimeter a few times an hour.
It seems like they're fighting a lot, though. Maybe not.
And of course, every now and again, some friendly folks, like yourself, will wander through here. And nothing beats a pleasant conversation. Though my comrade Horatius has quite different opinions on that matter.
Horatius was the one at the door? No, that was not him.
I can't remember who Horatius was, but what's his opinion?
Have you talked to him? Thinks every man, woman, and child who steps foot in this place wants to rob it blind.
If he's I not wrong.
Greet a townsperson with a hello instead of a state your purpose. He starts frothing on and on about godly duty and security breaches.
Okay.
Okay, what do you know about what's going on here?
This Jake business is quite the scandal, no? I myself suspect his wife, Esmeralda, and the butcher seconds that, let me tell you.
Oh, well, if the butcher seconds it.
Yeah, obviously.
Must be true.
Then again, and you didn't hear this from me, he's going through quite the nasty divorce himself, and there's his children to consider.
Okay.
But I imagine his youngest, Kimberly, won't mind, never did get on well with her mother ever since the incident.
Here we go.
Continue.
It's an unparalleled pleasure having a fresh ear around here.
What?
Let's talk to someone positive for once.
Have we met this butcher?
The butcher?
I don't think so.
Maybe he's around here.
Oh, here's Horatius. I can talk to him.
Keep your pleasantries to yourself. What are you doing inside this warehouse, snooping around?
I'm not doing anything unsatisfactory.
You're totally snooping around.
If it's conversation you're looking for, I'd recommend my comrade Florius, or as I prefer to call him, Loose Lips McGee.
Yeah, I like that. Loose Lips McGee. LLM.
As for myself, my job is to protect this warehouse, not chit-chat with intruders.
You seem to have strong opinions about Florius.
That idiot man-child would sooner spend an hour chaining up a thief than a minute arresting him. I only hope he gets transferred out of this warehouse and straight to the perimeter. Let him rot off a zombie's ear instead of mine.
He secretly loves him. It's fine.
Yeah,
I can
even
tell.
Thinking of him turns one into a gabbing hen. Please, leave me be.
Okay, so all I'm trying to do is figure out how do I get in there. And we're gonna have to somehow get these guys out of here at some point.
I found the orc.
Okay, where is the orc?
The other exit.
Alright, jump in there. Talk to it.
Ninius.
Prove an orc crusher to convince my dumbbell of a friend here that orcs are predators, not pets. Okay, conflict has arisen.
I know how dangerous an orc can be, but this one has been reformed. Anyone can see that she's completely docile, but my prejudiced friend here still wants to kill her.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie, and this is gonna sound weird, but that orc has a banging body. Am I wrong, though? I'm not wrong.
Hey, you said it.
Yeah.
You're not wrong.
Okay, thanks.
Maybe before the great orc raid we had time to indulge Ninius's idiotic obsessions. But now we're needed at our posts. I can hardly believe I've been wasting time protecting an orc when I should be running them through.
I know where this is going.
My friend's violent outbursts. He hasn't enjoyed a woman's touch in quite some time now. It makes him a bit edgy.
Edgy.
Your woman's touch is less of a loving caress and more of a claw shanked
this is Sean Connery.
Through the throat.
Yeah.
I'll take my chances as a bachelor, thanks.
Like a drunk Sean Connery.
Yeah, like a terrible one.
My friend here and I were patrolling outside the city walls when who did I see creeping along the shore but this lovely orcish lady.
She's purring?
For a brief second.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
As long as eternity, we locked eyes.
Okay.
Oh, this is getting weird.
Confused by the butterflies in her stomach, she sprang up and began running, claws bared towards Marius.
Yeah, confused.
Fortunately for him, I had the presence of mind to ignore my sword and instead adroitly fling my pouch of trinkets towards her.
Okay.
A vial of love potion shattered
Okay.
And when she turned to face me, she became instantly enamored.
Yeah.
You don't seem too disappointed by that.
I'm sure she must have been compelled to join the orcish army under some kind of duress. A lady with such a sweetly
her duress such as birth
would never willingly join up with those vicious marauders.
Of course not.
I can assure you there wasn't a hint of sweetness in those murderous eyes when she lunged at my throat. She may be confined here for now, but who's telling when she'll escape and who she'll rip to shreds?
A love potion? I'm kind of curious about this. Did you hear that?
Yeah, I should hit something. It's weird.
I've always so had weird. An amateur interest in all things alchemical. When
maybe
I
we can
read
get the,
an esteemed periodical from the Wizards of Youthful Gore about an amazing opportunity that could change my life, I had to act fast or lose the once-in-a-lifetime deal.
Oh, yeah, I know what you mean.
I sent away for the world-famous love potion, available for a limited time only, and it has worked exactly as promised.
Only $9.99.
You see what a fool my friend has been, spending all his cash on snake oil. And bringing a temporarily tranquilized monster into our midst to boot.
Actually, I believe it's worked.
What monster would lie?
Yeah.
I just don't know how long it lasts.
I'm sure the effects of the potion will be everlasting, as printed.
As, of course.
Yeah, no, yeah, wrong.
Okay, let me tell you what I think.
You see? He'd believe it was noon at midnight if he read it on a printed pamphlet. Please tell me you can reason with him, or ditch reason and use your sword to shave him from his murderous darling.
This sound is so creepy.
It is, it's weird.
Okay,
I'm gonna try not to look at your possible, like, thing, like, at your responses.
Okay.
I'm just gonna wait for it.
Okay, she's gotta be put down. If this love potion is as dodgy as it sounds, she could come to her vicious senses at any time.
She's got to be put down. If this love potion is as dodgy as it sounds, she could come to her vicious senses at any time.
Okay, I actually disagree. Not for, like, a mercy's sake, but I think we could ask her questions to figure out what's going on.
What's the point in causing more pain in this beleaguered city? Question her and see what comes of it.
I agree with that. We should question her.
All right, we'll do it your way.
Odd wins again.
Bravo.
Well, it makes sense.
I trust not only the potion, but my scaly
skin. We can still kill her later.
In and of myself.
Okay, so, does this mean...
Okay.
Oh, wait, Medora has something to say, I think.
A man in love with an orc? Blummin' bullfrogs. Is he blind, stupid, or both? Imagine the hell-sent mongrel that'll crawl forth from that union. Why didn't you put her down while you had the chance?
Oh, she's not happy. Okay.
Yeah. I kind of agree with her.
Upon my fair
fanged filly. I mean, I think we still have time to put her down.
Medora? Does the thought of interbreeding sicken you so? For my part, the union itself is hardly a problem, and I claim that anyone opposed to the couple on those grounds is small-minded indeed.
Avert your gaze, and I'll handle this threat for all our sakes.
I should take the second one, but I'm gonna go with the first one. One doesn't have to be small-minded to see the risk of allowing another race of half-demons to infect Rivalon.
That's right. I'd rather have a small
you're taking her
still
side.
Attached to my body
I got it.
Than an open one ripped in half. I imagine that if you haven't seen what I've seen, it's rather easy to enjoy some favorable doubt towards those hellspat demons.
I get it. I do get it.
That said, make no mistake, if I'd seen evidence, any indication at all, that an orc were more than either a bloodthirsty hellhound or a bloodthirsty hellhound in a clever disguise, I'd be the first in line to bless any such mixed-up union.
Okay, that's weird. I only have one option.
Voice it.
And it's the other one that I can select it from.
Okay. That's exactly it. You lot can go on about love all you want, but my opposition is based on one fundamental...
Okay, no, it's slightly different.
Yeah.
An orc is incapable of love. Let the elves mix with the imps and the dwarves with undead for all I care. But keep those blasted orcs out of the equation.
I disagree with that.
Your gaze,
now, don't get me wrong. If I'd seen evidence, any indication at all, that
yeah, weird. We've just kind of gone through both.
Either a bloodthirsty hellhound, or a bloodthirsty hellhound in a clever disguise, I'd be the first in line to bless any such mixed-up union.
Okay. Well, thanks, Medora. That's fantastic.
She likes orcs. I'm getting that impression.
Yeah, weird. I'm gonna talk to the orc.
Do it. Sounds like she has a lot to say, Odd.
Well, she did say that. It's weird.
Bringing your little mistress girlfriend.
Okay,
here
so
is like
interesting.
No
charmed, I'm sure.
Listen, she's purring.
We met two Sisile guards arguing about whether to kill her, and we convinced them to let her live.
Love potion
no!
But it's not over yet.
From youthful gore.
So that's probably not going to go well. Did we talk to this Moira?
Well, a source hunter.
Yes.
About time the cat.
All right. Here's what I think. If you have another idea, you let me know.
Okay.
But I think. Hold on.
You want to get into there, don't you?
I so badly want to get into here, but this dickweed is staring right at me. Hey, can you just go distract him for just on the other side of him and talk to him for a sec?
Yeah, sure. I'll use my womanly charms.
Okay, I got a couple people moseying around here, and I'm gonna make this work.
You're gonna sneak up right behind him, aren't you?
No, I'm going into this one first.
Okay.
But there's too many people!
So, Sergeant Curtis.
Yeah, just like flirt him up a little bit. I'm gonna just
tell me more about yourself, please, Sergeant Curtis. Ooh, yes.
Okay. Door's open. I don't know if I can go in without them freaking out.
This place reeks of orc stench.
And what's in that room again? I'm sorry.
Oh god!
Did you get caught?
No, she's not very happy about it.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh shit. Okay. Well, the door's closed.
I'll take my leave.
The door's closed and I'm inside. Okay. Teleport in here. No, wait, don't. I might need to teleport out.
Can't you teleport to me?
I could. I'm just gonna. There's a whole bunch of stuff in here.
Can you grab it?
I mean, I can do anything I want. So.
Oh.
There's all this stuff. There's a whole bunch of empty cups and bottles that I'm gonna take.
Okay.
Empty potion bottles. I don't know if empty bottles actually help us with anything, but I know empty potion bottles do.
I wonder if there's another way we can get into this room.
There's gotta be. Well, I guess it doesn't have to be.
This place reeks. Well, we could just kill all
bastard
them.
Sort. We could, but yeah, that would be kind of setting a precedent in town that we don't really need.
You think?
Okay, I've got midnight oil scroll and a blank water scroll. Some corn.
Was it me or did like a four-leaf clover appear over your head?
He awaits your queries for a second.
I don't know.
Okay.
Can you scroll through the thing at the bottom?
Mate,
yeah.
I got potatoes. Slow down arrowhead.
Just a turn of phrase.
Lock picks. More. Oh, it's wheat that I had, not corn. Potatoes. Man, I'm just literally robbing these guys blind. I stole a washing tub.
Well, what's this I've spotted?
A washing tub?
Oh, we found a hatchet? I should actually be doing this with him.
Right before that dialogue.
Okay, I've pretty much taken everything that
it just said, got a lucky find. That's what it was. Would be quite a bit better if I could do it in. I don't know what that means, but
okay, I think I'm just gonna get out of here.
Do I need to distract anyone?
No, I'm just gonna come to you.
Did we talk to this Pablo guy?
Please turn your phrases elsewhere.
Oh, he's
a burning ship guy
again. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. I'm not sure how we're gonna get in here. But what I can say is
we will.
Oh, someday. You know what I'm thinking? Well, maybe not, but I'm almost wondering if the fact that the orc was talking about like that charm spell, maybe we could charm this guy at some point. And
right, or if we could get the orc, if we could dispel the spell on the orc, maybe she'll start attacking people and we can get in.
Yeah, she'd have like a ruckus and then we could get in there. I'm gonna have a charm spell in at level 6, so we could try it, see what happens.
Okay, for now,
yeah. For now, honestly, I think we go west and we work towards one of the first quests that we ever had, which is that strange cave. And there are going to be orcs out here. So we could take one of those fights, maybe?
Yep, for sure.
Okay, let's talk to the guy and just to validate our strength.
I think we got it this time.
I think so, too. Let's see what he says, if anything.
Still thinking about exploring the beach? You're free to go, though we Legionnaires are under strict orders never to abandon our posts, so we won't be able to back you up.
Open the gate!
Certainly, though it's a shame we can't lend you our swords on your expedition.
Okay, nice.
Okay, cool. I feel good about this.
Yes.
Look alive, my
mostly because
man.
He feels good about this.
Old buckler.
Now, we've checked all of these bodies on the way out here, I'm pretty sure. Because we're greedy, and I'm sure that we've done this. Yeah. Okay, so you lead the way, because you know what's going to happen.
The Caecilians
or have we been out?
No, no, we haven't been out this way.
Okay.
Either they've taken to the sea or
set
up
they still have a bunch of stuff.
Caves. Keep your weapon ready.
Thank God. Been needing some of that.
I know. I need more hair.
Okay, we've got a thing over here. We have Charla. And he has a magic ward.
Okay.
Shall I approach?
Well, let me get closer to you in case we have to fight her or him.
Okay. There's like, I don't want to. Oh, that would have been stealing. Okay, let me talk to this Charla. Oh. Yeah, don't steal. Don't
Why
steal.
Is it stealing?
Probably because it's Charla's.
Hello.
Okay.
What have we here?
Nice face.
An adventurer, I judge by the world-weary look of your weapon, and a noble by the wonderfully deep pockets clipped to your belt. What luck? What luck?
Okay, so this is like a merchant of some kind. I'm just gonna take a look at what she has to sell.
Okay, I'll just sit here twiddling my thumbs.
Okay, I'll tell you what she has. First aid skill book, which for an expert marksman wouldn't be bad. Scoundrel, not bad.
Okay.
Weaken a target. Yeah, okay. Whirlwind skill book, I think you have that already, right?
Got that.
Okay. Now there's some kits. An adventurer's sword, axe, staff, or a bow.
Okay.
And there's it's like a base kit. So it must be something that we like build over time-ish.
We can craft it or something.
That's kind of what I'm thinking. It's slightly better than what I have right now for a bow. So I might actually pick this up.
Okay.
And the sword is, it's a one-handed sword, 29 to 50 damage. Do you think you probably have more than that.
I do. Does it have any kind of bonus, though?
It doesn't, but it looks
but
like
you can
there's
build
like,
on it.
Yeah, it looks like there's like sockets or something.
Okay, well, I mean, if you can afford it, then get it. I have 179 gold right now.
Okay, you might have to buy it from her then, because I don't think I can afford both.
Okay.
Otherwise, she has like some miscellaneous items, some scrolls, a couple of potions. She has a resurrect scroll.
What is she wearing? We wanted to get resurrect scrolls too, right?
Yeah, I'll just sell some random stuff that will help me get this scroll. Okay, let's do this. So I have a scroll and I got that weird thing. Let's ask her about herself.
Charla is my name, good friend.
Ooh,
I came to the second life some time ago, some years. Years it must be, or perhaps not.
So you
second
don't
life.
Know anything?
In any case, has been time well spent hunting out magnificent goods and selling them to interested parties.
Okay.
So many wonderful artifacts I've found, so many precious relics I'd be so happy to rehome to a trusted buyer.
I just realized we probably should have, like, talked to her first. Maybe get, like, a deal or something on purchased goods.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of wares do you have on hand?
Have a look by all means. You'll find every make and kind of impressive accessories, but you'll also find certain very rare relics, too. You look like just the sort of self-starter to appreciate what I mean. Weapons, four of them, that the intrepid adventurer can improve and upgrade as he travels.
Oh, that's okay,
right,
cool.
Pieces. See
okay.
them? See them? Judge for yourself.
If he finds the right pieces. Okay, that worries me.
Bye then, good friend. Goodbye. That is, unless you fancy a glance at some of my wonderful goods.
Already done that, thanks. You go ahead if you want to take a look.
Does she seem trustworthy, though? Look how she's dressed.
I don't... Yeah, she's totally sketchy, and she's died, it sounds like. Like, this is her second life, right?
Yeah, well, maybe not died. Maybe she did something before that...
Well, whatever.
...enjoy, but she looks pretty powerful. Okay.
What would I combine this with, man? This is bizarre.
Got a lot of stuff to sell, actually.
Does she have a lot of money? I didn't even notice. I could have offloaded a bunch of stuff.
She's got 11 gold.
Okay, that's not bad.
I'm gonna hang on to this. This Peter Lee sword is interesting. Might want to use that instead. Gives me more initiative.
Whatever you think, man. I'm just picking flowers.
Of course you are. Where's this thing?
It's weird that some of these are stealing and some of these aren't.
Keep that. This. I'm gonna hang on to these three just in case.
What is it that you're trying to buy?
I'm trying to get this starter sword.
Oh, you are? Okay, so you are gonna buy the sword.
Yeah, it's only 93.
Cool.
And then...
Wait, I think it was cheaper for me.
Oh, what's your bartering skill?
That's what I'm looking at right now. One. That's why.
Okay, so maybe you should be buying the stuff. I'll just give you the gold.
I mean, it's pretty insignificant, but if you want me to do it...
It adds up. Okay, I sent you...
Does she have any coupons we can use, maybe, while we're at it?
Jesus.
Is there a Groupon offer for her starter swords? So are you going to pass me money to buy this thing, or you already did it?
I already did. Well, so can you get the battle axe as well?
From her?
Yep.
Like, buy it?
The starter battle axe.
I have 491 gold. Oh, yeah. How do I have that much gold all of a sudden?
I gave you 400.
Yes, okay, so you
friend.
Did.
I'm yeah. quite busy finding for the moment, but if there's something you'd like to buy, I can set
the adventurer's axe
for a few delicious moments.
Yes. It's two-handed, right?
Two-handed base kit. Yep. That's what you cool. want?
Yeah, and the adventurer's sword.
Well, so we're buying everything.
Yeah, sure, why not?
All right. Considering we don't know how to upgrade it.
It's not that much. It's like 200.
Yeah, it's true. We're super rich.
I think we're about to be. All right, send the axe Medora's way.
I sent them both to you. It's much too late, my friend.
No.
I'm getting out of here. Good luck keeping up.
I can just port to you. I'll send you a scroll. You'd like to use those.
Okay.
Okay, this shield's better. Maybe.
We have a guy. We have a dude crying over here.
Okay, I'm coming over there.
And he's got a name. And he doesn't look hostile. Do you want me to go talk to him?
Yeah, go for it. What is that? A totem?
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Why with your weapons? Why? Leave Umbul Orc.
Morn, okay.
What are you doing here, dude?
I don't want to fight. I ain't after no fancy stone. I just want to bury these bodies the traditional way. It's the least I could do for my dear brother, Oggy.
I ain't after no fancy stone. I just want to bury these bodies the traditional way.
One of those star stones.
The star
maybe.
Stones, I think.
Oh, it was such a dear lad he was. We wanted to see the world, but we saw next to nothing before he was called to serve the old mother in the afterlife.
Okay, so what's this traditional way of burying them?
In our village? Oh, poor Oggy will never see her again. Tradition goes that a warrior should be buried with his best armor so he can defend himself in the afterlife.
Ooh, armor.
Okay.
There weren't so many spoiled after the battle, but I managed to give old Oggy the best set. A proud send-off for a proud soldier.
But can we wear orc armor? It seems a bit big.
Oh, because, okay, I see where this is going.
I'd like to get that.
I mean... I'm interested.
I know you're interested.
God. What have I become? What have I become?
A grave with a full set of hand-picked armor, eh? We've got to know its location.
I totally agree.
I second that.
His brother won't be using that armor.
We're terrible.
Now that he's gone to the great orc sty in the sky.
He's an orc.
Orc sty.
We'll have to fight him at some point.
Are we though?
You want the location of Oggy's grave? Now what use could you have for that, small bones? Keep bothering about it, and I may have to call over my friends from up the beach to deal with you.
I'm shaking.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, I'm not super confident.
Corpses with loot. Hand me my shovel.
First one to strike gold buys dinner.
Oh, Medora.
That pathetic heap of source-addled frogskin thought it could fool us, did it? Old Medora knows for certain that orc would have loved nothing better than to axe you in the back while it cried on your shoulder.
I like Medora.
I think she has very strong opinions, and that's fine, but I also believe that people need to be flexible.
Okay, I'm not going to read your options.
What else but a tainted source being could sail to peaceful size deal with the intention of making war? Damn his sob story to the hell he came from. Oh. I'm more interested to hear how she reacts when I ask her. What kind of source hunter can't show us an ounce of compassion to someone who's obviously bereft?
Pretty sure I know she's... Oh, okay, I get to react.
You'll have to voice this one.
Yeah. More vigilant one than you, that's for certain. You're gonna be sorely surprised if you expect our enemies to... not to use your compassion against you.
Well, I didn't mean to imply that compassion is an unequivocally bad thing, you know?
Okay, good.
Hasn't a source hunter gotta be judicious about when to grant it?
Yeah, I agree with
I've
that.
I've yet to meet an orc who'd earned a soft hand. Though I suppose old Medora'd be perhaps overly dismissive to imagine that one could never exist.
Actually, to my count, we've met 3 orcs now, and none of them have tried to hurt us.
That's true.
So, just saying.
Yeah, but one of them was raised by humans, and the other one was charmed.
Don't care. This one seems upset.
That's not true. The first orcs that we met attacked us.
Okay, fine. That's true. Okay. This is a level 20 totem. What does that mean?
Oh, we can't kill it.
It means it's a stronger totem than we are? I understand.
Than us, than we'll ever be.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's take a break here. I'm just kind of scouting ahead. I see some footprints. I see fire barrels. And I see a ship. And I see dead people. And I see a cave entrance.
Dead people?
Dead legion. Legionnaires.
Ooh.
Yeah, so I know it's shaken up ahead.
Yeah.
But I know where the cave entrance is, so that's cool too, right?
Awesome.
All right, let's take a break here, and when we come back, I'm sure it's going to be action-packed, probably.
Can't wait.
See you guys next time. Bye.